Our next speaker is all the way from Singapore. He is on the Hangout right now. Chandu Kavar works as a data engineer at Grab Singapore. Chandu has 4+ years of experience working in big data technologies such as Hive, Spark, Impala, Presto, Airflow, EMR, etc. Chandu enjoys playing table tennis and is also a blogger. Chandu, can you present at the Hangout?
Yeah.
Could you make me a presenter so I can?
Yes.
Okay. My name is Chandu. I'm working for Grab Singapore. So today I will talk about testing in Airflow and what are the things that we can test. So previously I was working for ThoughtWorks, so we are more focused on testing as well. So this talk is a lightning talk, so I will give you the high level idea about the testing. So think about the testing in traditional web app, where we have a client, server, and database. So we mostly tend to write unit tests, integration tests, functional tests. And if there is a very complex or a large-scale application, we used to write stress testing or a snapshot testing or a few other categories of test. So what can we test in Airflow? So you might have seen there are some broken DAGs on the UI. So when I join the Grab on the prod UI, I can see few DAGs not able to input or parse by Airflow. So because of some typos or a cyclicity in the DAG, or let's say you want to enforce all your developer to have some mandatory parameters, let's say owner of the DAG, or you might have a email in the DAG. So basically you can enforce the mandatory parameter as well. Other thing you can test is how many tasks in that one DAG, what are the type of the task I mean operator. So Python operator, whatever the type of operator. We can also test upstream and downstream dependencies of each task. We also might have a custom operator and sensor. So we can test that logic of the custom operator and sensor. There might be integration test between two tasks if we have used XCOMs. And at the end, we can test end-to-end pipeline to verify the result of the full pipeline. We can run on actual infrastructure as well. So if I will divide all this test into a categories, so there will be a 5 categories. One is DAG validation test. It will check the correctness of your DAG. Basically, it will check the typos, it will check the cyclicity of the DAG, it will check the mandatory parameter on each DAG. And this DAG validation test will be common for all the DAGs. You don't need to write a test for each DAG. It will be high level sanity of all your DAGs. The second will be a pipeline definition test. It is more like a snapshot testing in web app. What it does is it verifies whether your changes are intentional or not. Whenever you change the dependency of any task or whether you introduce a new operator, this test will fail. So you need to fix those tests as well. So this is like when you add all this, you have to confirm with the test as well. So the third one will be unit test. It will be for your custom operator and sensor. So 4th and 5, I'm working on it. It is out of the scope for this presentation. So let's take an example of a sample DAG. The DAG we have is a Hello World DAG, and it has three operators, the dummy operator, Python operator, and one is custom operator, the multiply by 5 operator. And then dummy operator have a downstream dependency on Hello operator and multiply by 5 operator. So what my custom operator is do is whatever argument you pass, it will multiply by 5 and it will return me. So to write a DAG validation test, the first test you can see here is a test import DAGs. What it does is it will check from the DAG bag. So in DAG bag, as you might aware that it's all DAGs that Airflow has. So it will verify the DAG will be parsable in Airflow or not in the unit test itself. So you won't see broken DAGs on the UI if you have this test. So this test will check all the DAGs parsable using Airflow. The second test we have is a queue present. I'm checking that each and every DAG should have this a queue as a in default argument. If any DAG does not have a queue, this test will fail. So this is how you can write the DAG validation test. You can add more tests based on your requirement. So DAG definition test, as I mentioned, it is a kind of snapshot. What it does is it will check the number of tasks in the DAG. So here you can see I have a DAG ID hello world. And for this DAG, how many tasks in that particular DAG? If we will add one more operator, we have to change this test. Then you can also check what are the type of tasks using task ID. Whatever the task ID you had given, you can read it from DAG bag, and then you can check that this DAG should contains this number of tasks. You can also write the dependencies. You can test the dependency as well. So here is the test for dependency of dummy task. So you can get that task from the DAG bag, and then you can have a session on the upstream and downstream dependency. So this is just to verify the whether you are making the changes are intentional or not. So the custom operator that we have written, whatever the logic is in execute method, and we want to test the execute method. So this is a test for that. So what here I did is created sample DAG and then add the multiply by 5 operator in that DAG. And then I had created a task instance. If I will execute this task instance using a value as a 10, then it should return me a 50. So this is how you can add all your tests to verify your operator logic or custom sensor logic. So all the codes related to this presentation and few more you can find in this repo for more reference. And also I have a blog post on Medium for first three, and I'm working on fourth and five. Yeah, that's it.
Questions for Chandu, anyone?
Okay. Thanks.
There is one question. Hold on.
So quick question. So I'm curious, like you have mentioned about operators that seem to can safely test locally. What if you have operators that involves a remote system, say a Spark job operator? How would you test in that case?
So I think whatever the operator that provided by Airflow, that I think already tested in Airflow code base. Whatever the custom operator that you will write, you need to test only that, right? And all the integration between your pipeline, you will have a end-to-end pipeline test on small scale. Basically, you will set up some data, then you will run whole pipeline, and you will assert on the output of all your output at the end of your DAG.
Got you. Thanks. Is this something you are already doing, or like that's something you plan to do?
So I'm working on integration test and end-to-end pipeline test. Might be using Docker or some dev environment, basically. So it will have a same setup like your production. So you can test all your pipeline based on the Jenkins. If someone will change that particular DAG, that end-to-end pipeline will trigger. It will run on sample data, and it will verify the output of that particular pipeline.
Cool, thanks.
Yeah, welcome.
Thank you, Chandu.
Yeah, welcome.